Clay was amazing tonight, not just the 35 points and the 9 threes, but his defense. You know, the guy's a machine. I mean, he's just so fit physically, and he seems to thrive in these situations. But he was fantastic.
Janie McCauley from AP. The sequence there early in the fourth, where you guys, Nick Young was the point person on Harden, and you got two defensive stops, and then Clay's three. How big was that?
I mean, the fourth quarter defense was fantastic. I thought Nick Young did a great job defensively. Gave us 16 big minutes. This has been a war of attrition this series, and I went away from Nick last game, went to Quinn, and came back to Nick this time, and I thought he handled himself really well. He made a beautiful catch and go, catch and drive, and pass to Sean Livingston for a big basket. But his defense was what really stood out.
Anthony Sutter with The Athletic. How much of the strategy tonight was just kind of push at all costs? It seems like make or miss. You guys were really trying to run it up one.
Yeah. We wanted to push, made or miss. We want to do that all the time, but for whatever reason, we haven't been doing that in this series. So we did a better job of that tonight. I thought it was kind of a strange game because our defense has been really good throughout the series, and tonight it was awful to start the game. We lost people in transition. We didn't communicate. We gave up wide open threes. They scored 39 points in the first quarter, and it was sort of a head scratcher. You know, like I was more worried about the offense coming into the game than the defense. But the defense eventually kicked in, and obviously that led to transition, and the shot making in the second half was just amazing.
Steve Mark, Medina Bay Area News Group. Tonight in this season, what's it been about the third quarter that brings the best out of you guys?
Just incredible halftime adjustments. Coaching staff is the main thing. I don't know. I think our guys, all season long, they've played great third quarters. I think they tend to get dialed in a little bit more. Tonight was a pretty good microcosm of our team in many ways. We have these lapses, and then we have these bursts and everything in between. So it's a strange start to the game. You could tell Houston could see it. They could see the finals right here. And we kind of thought they would come out hot because this was a little bit of a free swing for them. Game six on the road. They know they got game seven in their back pocket at home. So they came out loose. I thought they would shoot 53s tonight. They got 39, but it seemed like 50 to me early in the game, and that's where it was heading. But I think once we settled down defensively and started staying with people and not making mistakes in transition, then we wore them down a little bit.
Coach El Sarasovic, center back here. This was a pretty schizophrenic game. You started talking about it right there, and it seems like that's been a thread throughout the whole season. What do you think was wrong in the first half, and other than the great halftime adjustments that you talked about, how they look like two different teams out there.
Yeah. If you have any idea, please let me know. I have no clue why our team is like this, but this is kind of what we do. We're up and down a little bit. But the one thing I do know is that our guys, they have a ton of character and a ton of competitive desire. They're champions. So our guys, they compete. That's the main thing. They may not always focus, but they compete.
Melissa Rowland, Bay Area News Group. After what was relatively a slowish start for Stephen Curry, what did you think of the way he went on to trust his shot and affect the game?
Steph was fantastic. Early in the game, he and KD really struggled, and it seemed to me we were in a big rush. We were passing up layups to try to shoot threes in transition. We were launching threes just without a thought of maybe getting a better shot. And then I think once we kind of settled down and got back in the game and cut it to 8 or 10 points, I think we kind of calmed down. I think Draymond at halftime used the John Wooden line. He said, "Be quick, but don't hurry." And nobody's ever said it better than John Wooden. That's the game of basketball. Be quick, but don't hurry. We were in such a hurry that first maybe 18, 20 minutes. We kind of settled in.
Steve, Mark Schwartz, ESPN. This game was reminiscent for Clay of 2016, Oklahoma City. You're also down 3-2. He gets 41 that night. Is there a quality about him in a desperate situation with the team facing elimination that allows him to produce these type of performances?
Yes. I think Clay doesn't worry too much about repercussions. He doesn't worry about judgment and results. And I think he just loves to play. And he's so comfortable in his own skin. I just think he wants to go out there and hoop, and he doesn't worry about much else. And so the pressure doesn't seem to bother him much. He just competes and plays. And as I said, the two-way ability of this guy, hounding the MVP of the league, most likely, all game and continuing to rain down three-pointers. He's amazing.
Steve, Tim Calcon, The Athletic. After last game, there's a lot of discussion about Durant in isolation, and you said you'll take the mismatch every time. But was there some, it looked like you went away from that in this game. Was there some adjustment to kind of go away from Durant on the post every single time and go more perimeter-oriented?
Yeah, we've been trying to get kind of back to being us. All series. I think Houston's done a great job of defending us, switching everything. They've got they've built a great roster to do what they're doing. You know, they've got size and strength at every position. And you know, sometimes you kind of have to figure it out in terms of the ball movement, and it's, you know, a lot of this stuff is different for us because of the switching 1-5. So I think we've been trying to get more and more movement and mix in the KD ISOs against the mismatches. And tonight, obviously, we did a better job of finding the balance.
Steve, Rick Tittle, 95.7 the game over here.
Right side.
Did you expect Jordan Bell to get 21 minutes helping fill that Iguodala void, or did he just play his so well that you had to leave him out there?
We kind of knew that Jordan and Looney would share a lot of minutes out there. There were a few minutes in the game where we go smaller, but generally one of them is going to be out there. This team is so difficult to guard because of the isolation ability, and you know that's why we're playing our young mobile bigs with Looney and Jordan. But you know, I give Jordan a lot of credit. He didn't play at all in the first two rounds of the playoffs, but he stayed ready, really worked hard on his conditioning. And every matchup's different. Every team that we play is different. And this team that we're playing now requires really mobile, big defenders.
Tony Harvey, second officer. Coach Kerr, the Warriors are now 4-1 in elimination games since 2015. Now you have the final game coming up. Another 48 hours, and I know you're not thinking about that right now, but what is it going to take, you know, to get your team over the edge on the road?
Hopefully we don't fall down by 17 right away. We'd like to get off to a better start, but we like our formula, we like our defense against these guys, and we feel confident that we can carry this through to game 7 on the road and continue to make things as difficult as possible on Houston without fouling. I thought that was a real key tonight. We didn't reach. We reached so often in game 5. And when they go to the line, it's free points. It's a rest for James and Eric Gordon. So we want the game to keep going. And we have to be disciplined enough to not reach and not commit fouls. And the other factor is turnovers. The team that has won the turnover battle has won every game in this series. So that's critical.
Two more.
Anthony Slater with the Athletic. Do you have any optimism of Andre Iguodala potentially playing in Game 7, or are you going into preparing, operating under the assumption he won't play?
Yeah, I mean, we're operating under the assumption that he will not play, but he literally is just his day-to-day because there's it's a bone bruise. There's not sort of a timetable. It's more just up to the individual and how he's feeling, and we don't really know. So we'll just keep taking it day by day. We'll see what happens.
Their defense was sort of forcing you to get jammed up a little bit. How did you finally shake loose? Was it their defense relaxing, or you guys able to move the ball?
We did a better job moving the ball tonight for sure. The pace was really fast, and I thought the one positive of Houston getting off to that start that they did was the pace was high, and I didn't like the poor defense we were playing, but I liked the pace, and so I think once we settled down and we got the defense in a better position. Then we started moving the ball, and the game felt more like a Warriors game. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.